Morning to all. Today we are going to start the second chapter in fourth unit, nothing but web app design. In this chapter, we have 10 concepts. Those are nothing but first one, web app design quality, design goals, the design pyramid for web apps, web app interface design, aesthetic design, content design, architecture design, navigation design, component level design, object oriented, hypermedia design methods. So these are the 10 concepts are there in web app design concept. So before entering into the concept, just we will discuss what is mean by web app design. So what is mean by a web app? A web app means, we already discussed, it is a web application which is run on the basis of internet. And the concept now what we are going to discuss is how to design such web applications. So there is nothing but web app designing. So in that, according to these 10 concepts, the first concept is web app design quality is the first concept. So what are the different qualities are available in web app design? Now we are going to discuss in this video. So based on web app design quality concept, the qualities are broadly classified into two concepts. One is technical attributes, the second one quality attributes. Among these two, first we are going to discuss about what is meant by technical attributes. In technical attributes, we have 5 attributes are there for web app qualities. The first two attribute is usability, second one functionability, and third one reliability, and the fourth one efficiency, and the last one maintainability. Then come to the first attribute of technical attributes, usability. Usability means how the user use this. So he wants to use this in globalized format, that means global site understandability. So whatever the design you are developed for web app, it must be understood globalized, that means so throughout the world they want to understand you are designing. So in such manner the usability must be there, and online feedback and help features must be available in your development of web application. Then what is the interface you are developed for your web application? This must be aesthetic, and it may contain some aesthetic features also. Aesthetic means most attractive features must be there, and some other special features also you need to add for your web application design. Man, in this manner you must be provide the usability of your web application. So that is your first attribute of technical attributes, usability. Then second one is functionalities. So in your web app, what are the different functionalities you must be placed? Means the most important functionality is searching. So you must provide the most efficient searching functionality in your web application. And the second one, you must provide most efficient retrieving capability also. So these two are more important functionalities what you want to place in your web application. One is searching facility, and second one is retrieving capability. So whatever the data you want to search in the web application, you may search more effectively, and you can retrieve that data into a high capable manner. The next concept what you want to, or next functionality what you want to provide in your web application is navigation. So navigation means in your web application you can navigate, that means move from one place to another place without having any problem. Easily you need to move from one place to another place. It is possible by providing hyperlinks. Then next one, browsing features. So when you are developing a web application, browsing features are also most important. When you browse the data, it must provide the data, and all the browsers wants to support these things. So there is nothing but browsing features. Then application domain related features. So what basis the web app is developed based on that domain related features also you want to provide in the web application. So these are the points we need to discuss about functionality attribute. Then the third attribute is nothing but reliability. So in the reliability attribute, we need to discuss some of the concepts are nothing but correct link processing. That means this is related to navigation things. For example, in our web application, if you click any link, it must provide the right related concept to you. That means that comes under the point of correct link processing. Then the next one is error recovery. If you done any errors in your web application, that one must be recovered by your web app. It may not create any problem to the user. Then the third one is user input validation and recovery. Whenever a user providing any input to your web application, that data must be, or that input must be verified, and it must be recovered. If the user lost anywhere, it must be recovered. So all these points are related to the attribute called reliability. And the fourth attribute is efficiency. So efficiency means how efficiently your web application wants to provide the facilities to the users. On the basis of that, some of the efficient concepts are nothing but one is response time performance. How your web application responding to the user, how fastly it is responding. So whenever a user accepting or using any application, it must respond very fastly. Then the second concept is page generation speed. Whenever a user click any page, it wants to generate with high speedly. Then graphical generation speed also. So whenever there is any image or any graphics, it wants to load very fastly. So if all these things are happen in a fast manner, then your web application are working in efficient manner. Then that is fourth attribute. Then the last attribute, none other than fifth attribute, is nothing but maintainability. Maintainability attribute. Maintainability contains some of the points, nothing but easy of correction. That means whenever if any problems or any corrections, editing concepts you need to do in your web application, it must provide an easy way of correcting your web application. Then adaptability, everyone may easily adapt your web application. So then extensibility, if in future if you want to extend your web application, that means you need to add some more features also, it may provide an easy way to you to extend. So these are the points we need to discuss in we may discuss in maintainability attribute. So these are the five different types of attributes, technical attributes available in web app designing. Then the second attribute is nothing but quality attributes. Quality attributes. There are five major quality attributes are given here. So those are nothing but security, second one availability, and scalability, and time to market. So security means so whatever the web application you are developed, it must provide security for the data and security for the user information also. In secured manner, the web application wants to maintain all the information. Then second attribute is availability. So your web application must be available to the users throughout the day. 24/7 it must be available to the user. Then scalability means at any critical situations also, your web application want to support to the users. For example, at the same time, hundreds of users are accepted your web application, it wants to support to all the users. So that comes under scalability. Then the last one is time to market. Time to market is not exactly an attribute, quality attribute, but even though we need to discuss under quality attributes. That means whatever the web application you have developed, it must be marketed to the in the market in a right time. So that is comes under time to market. So these are the two types of technical quality attributes and quality attributes are available in the development of web applications. So this is your first concept. Then the second concept is web app design goals. So whenever you are developing a web application or designing any web applications, what are the goals you want to
follow.
So Gene Kaiser suggested some set of design goals for web applications. So these goals are regardless or based on application domain size or its complexity. The design goals are suggested by Gene Kaiser are first one, simplicity. That means whatever the web application you are designing or developing, it must be more, it look like more simply. That's nothing but the first suggestion is simplicity. Then second suggestion is consistency. Consistency means the whatever the content you are placed in the web application, they may not create any difficulty or confusion or problem or ambiguity to the users. So in such manner you want to develop your web application. That is the second goal of Kaiser. Then the third goal is identity. That means your whatever the web application you are developed, it must be identical. That means it may not be copied from any others. So in that manner, that means copyrights must be owned by your web application, is yours only, that it may not be copied from anywhere. It must be identical. That is the third goal of web app designing. Then fourth goal is robustness. Robustness means your web application must be strong. Whatever the data or the information you have provided in that web application, it must be a strong one, a correct one, like that. So such features are available in your web application. It follows the fourth goal, nothing but robustness. Then the fifth goal is nothing but navigability. Navigability means by using your web application, a user can navigate from one page to another page, or from move from one place to his desired place easily. So navigation must be provided easily in your web application designing. So it is one of the goal in the development of web applications. Then the next goal is visual appeal. So visual appeal means, so your web application must be look like more attractive and open to all the users. So that's nothing but the last but one goal. Then the last goal is nothing but compatibility. That means your web application must be suited to all types of browsers and all type of users. Suitability must be provided to your web application. So that's nothing but compatibility. So these are the seven different goals provided by Gene Kaiser for the development of web applications. So this is your second concept. Then third concept is a design pyramid for web applications. So in this concept, we are going to discuss about how a web application is developing. For that, what are the other design concepts are required? So those design concepts are placed here in this concept. So this concept is discussing only what are the designs are required to develop a web applications, which are placed in the form of pyramid style. So the pyramid starts from top to bottom. So it contains some different designing concepts. First one is interface design, and second one aesthetic design, third one content design, navigation design, architectural design, and component designs. Then come to the first point. Interface design means for your web applications, how you want to develop your interface. Then second one, aesthetic design. Aesthetic design is how attractively your web application wants to design. Then what are the data you want to place in your web application, that comes under content design. Then how navigation wants to provide in your web application, that's discussed in navigation design. And about your architecture styles, what type of architecture formats you want to use, that one is discussed in architecture design. Then component based details are discussed in component design. So this concept is a very small concept, and it gives the details about what are the different designs you are using in the development of web applications. So basically six different types of design concepts are used in the development of web applications. So this is the concept of design pyramid for web applications. So other concepts we will discuss in next videos. Thank you.